to this video on Heron's formula. In the previous video, we discussed the use of Heron's formula in finding the areas of quadrilaterals. Today, we will solve an interesting question related to this. In the figure, the area of triangle PTS is 4 square centimeters and quadrilateral TQRS is a parallelogram. On the basis of the given information, find the area of triangle TNQ, parallelogram TQRS and the length of side PT. Friends, in the figure, the length of all the three sides of the triangle TNQ is given. By using Heron's formula here, we can easily find the area of this triangle. First of all, we will find its semi-perimeter, that is S. So let's assume the length of side TN as A, the length of side NQ as B, and the length of side QT as C. Now, S is equal to the sum of these three sides divided by 2. We will obtain S as 8 cm here. Now, we will find the value of S minus A, S minus B and S minus 3 within brackets. Now, by substituting the values of all these in Heron's formula, we will solve it like this. And we will get the area of triangle TNQ as 4 root 5 square centimeters. Friends, look at triangle TNQ and parallelogram TQRS carefully. Both of these are situated on the same base and between the same parallel lines. And we know that if a triangle and a parallelogram lie on the same base and between the same set of parallel lines, then the area of the triangle is half the area of the parallelogram. So, we can say that the area of triangle TNQ will be half of the area of the parallelogram. By writing this equation in this way, we can find the area of the quadrilateral TQRS. We will obtain the area of the quadrilateral TQRS as 8 root 5 square centimeter. In the next part, in triangle PTS, we need to find the length of PT. We know the area of the triangle PTS. Here, we don't have any information about the sides. If we can somehow find the height of this triangle, then using the formula for the area of triangle half multiplied by base multiplied by height, we can find the length of the base PT. Friends, you can pause the video and try to find a way to find the height. We are given the base TQ of triangle TNQ is 7 cm and we obtained its area as 4 root 5 square centimeters. We can find the height of this triangle by substituting their values in this formula. We will obtain its height as 8 root 5 by 7 cm. Friends, both these triangles, TNQ and PTS, are situated between the two parallel lines, PQ and SR. Therefore, the height of triangle PTS will also be 8 root 5 by 7 cm. Now, in this equation, we can easily find the value of PT, which is the base, by substituting the values of the area and the height. Pause the video and try. Here, we obtain the length of PT as 7 by root 5 centimeters. Friends, you can see that its denominator has an irrational number, that is root 5. If here you substitute the value of root 5, then you will have difficulty in getting the answer. Here, we can rationalize this by multiplying the denominator as well as numerator by root 5, such that we will get a rational number in the denominator. So now, we got the length of the PT equal to 7 root 5 divided by 5 cm. Friends, that's all in this session. Today, we solved a question using Heron's formula. In the next session, we will solve some more interesting questions. So see you in the next video. Thank you.